everyone, this is Honeywell, and we are playing Stardew Valley. It is Sunday the 14th. It's a big day. We have, it's harvest day. Yeah, we have a big pumpkin harvest. Queen of Salt should be on TV. Cloudy, mildly perturbed. And trout soup. Thanks. It seems we are a bit low on pepper poppers. Let's get another stack. And it is also the traveling merchant today. And we have a huge pumpkin harvest. And that harvest is going to, I mean, I've talked a little bit about the money. Like, money isn't like my main goal with this. Oh, I think I wanted to upgrade a tool, right? But we just unlocked the bus, and if we spend 10,000 to upgrade a tool, we're not going to be able to get starfruit seeds. Let's hold off on that until we get starfruit planted. It's because the tool upgrades aren't important immediately. So we'll wait on that. We need that diamond for... for the state fair, or the Stardew Valley Fair. Oh, and I didn't save a bottle of wine. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hmm. We still need a food. I was waiting for a purple mushroom to make a life elixir. But we haven't received a purple mushroom. Neither one of these fish are particularly good. We have an animal product, foraging, fruit. The fairy rose honey is worth as much as the wine, so that can be our artisan. The diamond is our mineral. We'll use a pumpkin for our vegetable. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hmm. We should still be fine. What else do we have going on here? And our pumpkin, or not our pumpkin, our preserve jar should pop today, but since we have pumpkins, we don't have to preserve. Oh, because it's a recycling machine. We don't have to, preserve cranberries. We can preserve pumpkins, which are worth like 966 gold a jar. So our money is going to be pretty okay. I haven't gone over the top with it, but just, I would say, what is it? 966 a pumpkin, and we're gonna have 640 pumpkins for the season. But we won't preserve all of those, but we'll have some other crops. I would say that we're going to have at least 600,000 more by the end of this year. So it's not like a huge amount compared to how much we could have done. But we're not going to be like poor about this. And I need to go get our hoe so we can fill in that one spot too. Let's get this bomb out of our inventory. Let's go. No. go take care of a few things. Like, go to see the traveling merchant, let out the animals, and then we'll get to the harvest and all that good stuff. Oh, hey, Robin. I don't want to miss her both days this week. Hi. Oh, you have just all the best stuff. So disappointing. Should I buy that pufferfish? No. If we have time, we'll do the hardwood. Harvest and replanting shouldn't take too much time, but I think that about everything, so. So just to be safe. Good morning. Who? Everybody is not Lita. There we go. I guess that we want the void mayonnaise and the duck mayonnaise. I guess, right? Good morning, ladies. Oh, it was brown eggs I was saving. Okay. I wonder if that Silver Star large milk is worth more than a Gold Star regular. I don't think it is. Let's just put it in there. When I say that, I mean for the fair. Should we do Pepper Poppers today too? Oop, and you may come out as well. Sell that. Do we need these apples? I don't think we do. We turned in the fodder bundle. I mean, if I wanted to, I could hang on to them to preserve, but I planted enough pumpkins to we need to get the harvest done. I planted enough pumpkins to last throughout winter, so I don't need to, like, stockpile produce in order to preserve them. Like, we're gonna have plenty. Let me get the hoe really quick. Because that one spot is gonna annoy me. Hi, Pam. It is so good to see you back to work. Very happy for you. Hey. Thanks. Much appreciated. Right. I do have work to do. Thank you for looking out for my best interests. Let me get back to the harvest. Okay. And okay. water? Good. And now, let's do this. And I'm just holding the seed packets in my hand and right-clicking. And it, like, as you pick the pumpkins, it replants the seeds. Which is good. Let us put a pumpkin in there. And then, oh, you horse. Go over there today. And we'll start getting these preserved. Oh, the only bad thing is they all look like they're going right. And oh, we can do more preserve jars, it looks like. Yes, please. Well, two more. Okay. That's good. Okay, that field is done. And let's get back to the pumpkins. Now, I think I said that I'm expecting probably about 600,000 from this harvest here. That's not including the star fruit wine that we're going to be doing in the greenhouse or anything like that. But this also isn't, I mean, it's a far cry from somebody who, like, kind of just has like a patch, you know, like a small patch of everything out in front of their farm. But I think I was reading a post, somebody on somebody on the Chucklefish forums, wants to plant like 1,200 crops. So when I say that, like our farm is like kind of like small, I'm comparing it to those farms that where people are trying to cover every single square of their farm in crops. Me, I'm just happy as long as we make enough money in order to buy the things that we want. That is enough for me. So, yeah, we need a good amount of money. But I also like not having harvest day be a big production. That is everything. We ran out of our pepper poppers. Yes, please. And I was kind of waiting for those last two to pop, but I guess that's foolish. Because this honey is worth a lot, and these don't even produce in the winter, so. So to try and sync them up now, it might just cost us money. Okay, and we'll do that there. Let's put our pumpkins away. One, two. Oh, okay. I guess there's still 300 there. That cranberry jelly isn't worth very much. Thinking about our fare box here. So there's no point in saving that. Right? Right. Maybe we should go fishing. See if we can't get a gold star fish. That would be good. And these cranberries, again, I'm running these through the seed maker. These cranberries, the regular ones, sell for 75 gold, the crop. The seeds sell for the same. And since there's the chance of producing multiple seeds, we're not losing money by doing that. I'm going to sell these gold and silver star ones. Just because we need to ship 30 of every item. And yeah. And just so I don't have to put them through there. I guess we'll go to the secret woods and then maybe try and fish for a little bit. That will finish up our day. Oh, we also wanted to make pepper poppers. Sell this honey. And I guess we'll do half again. And half again. We only use like two a day, so like this is like a week's worth almost. Oh, and we only have 12 peppers left. I think we still have some out in the chests. Out front though. No mixed seed. I was hoping for an ancient seed. Looks like the animals made their way back into the barn. We really need to fence them in so they quit wandering all over the place. In fact, maybe we'll use our lightning rods for that. Like, block off this area and then run them along. I don't know, we'll see. I know. I'm sure you you had all of the amazing stuff on Friday, and today was just the leftovers. That's better. And I think I saw we had like 180 hardwood. Which is really nice because that's enough to do the second upgrade on our house, and then the third upgrade with the cellar is only 100,000. So I think the first little bit of money that we get, I might just do the house instead of the animals because I really don't want to take care of the animals. And two, the cellar is a really nice addition to the game, and it's one of the things that I'm planning on using to increase our income without increasing our work that much. Yay, treasure! Oh, nice. Not upset about that. The more artifacts we get, we think we need 60 to unlock the sewer, so that is not a bad thing. And it feels like we haven't turned anything into Gunther in a long time. And these little spots, they increase your chance for treasure, but they also increase the bite speed. So they're really nice. We should also go fish in that lake right out, or the river outside Aaliyah's house. I think we need one more nightfish, a brim, to complete a bundle. And this carp is good just for sashimi, which we'll probably be taking with us into the Skull Caverns, just because it's a cheap food, so you can like... use it for healing as much as you want, and it doesn't have any buffs, so it won't override any food that you want, like any luck buffs or defense buffs that you put on. So it's a nice option for the Skull Cavern. And I think we'll probably go tomorrow to the Skull Cavern, maybe the Skull Cavern too. It's Sandy's birthday tomorrow. So, and we have 10,000 gold, plus we just sold a little bit of things. So we should have enough money to get some star fruit. If we only do like half a greenhouse, that's only like 54 seeds, which isn't that much money, like 20-ish thousand gold. Oh, that's exactly what we needed. Yeah, so I guess that's what we'll do. And maybe we'll peek our heads into the Skull Cavern and see what it's all about. There's a lava katana at the Adventurers Guild, which is a much better sword than what we have. I think it costs like 25,000 though. Depending on how bad it is in the Skull Cavern, we might buy that. I'm kind of hoping to hold out for to finding a prismatic shard, and then we can go to the desert and get the galaxy sword. But that could be like another ancient seed. Like, we might never get it. So if it's too much, if the caves are just too difficult with the weapon we have, we can always upgrade it. But if we don't need to, then we just save 25,000. Not a bad thing. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 192 hardwood. That is not bad. Every little bit over 150 is just hardwood for casks. So I definitely think our next upgrades are not going to be the coops. They're going to be, I wonder if these are worth anything. And by worth anything, I mean in terms of points for the fair. Seeds, those. One of those in there. I guess we'll just stand out here and do seeds. Let's put that in there and that in there, just in case. I'll look up on the wiki and see which ones might be better to bring, like which one will give us more points. Let's see. This all we need is the winter forage, and that's just going to be a matter of days, I'm sure. We need a tiger trout, which I think we can catch this season. Sardine, we don't have the tuna, but we can catch that in winter. Lake fish. We need the sturgeon. That one is a hard fish to catch. I'm pretty sure we can catch it in spring. We have the walleye, we just caught the brim, and we have the eel, so we can finish that bundle. So even our fishing bundle isn't bad. We need a tiger trout, a tuna, and a sturgeon, and then that's everything. That's not bad. Okay, let's sell these seeds and go to bed. And sell that too. No, we are going to bed. Hey, Holly. Oh no, run.
Get into bed. Yes, go to sleep for the night.
Oh, nice. 20,000? No, 23,000. That's good. Yeah, a little bit of money from the cranberries, the cranberry jelly, fairy rose honey. It just all adds up. Cranberry seeds. Very nice. We should have no problem getting to the desert and purchasing starfruit seeds. But that is going to end this episode. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for the likes and comments. They're always appreciated. And I hope you come back for the next one. Bye-bye.